Hi everyone, Vicky from Soul Studio, bringing you another How to Art video. Today, we're gonna do sculpting with tinfoil. So super easy, super fun. You don't need any special tools. All you need is some tinfoil and your hands. So grab a box of tinfoil, let's get started. Okay, so I have a piece of tin foil here. I have extra if I need it. I'm gonna show you how to do two things. First, I'm gonna show you how to make a snail. It's really cute and it's really pretty easy, and it can just kind of get you used to working with the tin foil. So, I didn't do a great job ripping this piece, but that's okay, because I'm actually aiming to have something a little bit longer like this end. So I'm gonna go ahead and first just actually start to roll this up. The first thing we're going to do here is actually make the snail shell. I'm going to roll that all the way up, and I'm going to just kind of squeeze it in between my fingers so that I can get it nice and kind of tight and compacted. Okay, so I have kind of a thinner end down here, so that's where I'm going to start from. And what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to start to kind of spiral that in to make our snail shell. So you can already see that's kind of starting to go there. Looks like it could be kind of a magic wand or a fiddlehead fern. You may have some of those in your garden right now because it's springtime. Okay, so maybe you have some snails in your garden right now, who knows? So I'm just gonna bring this around almost to the end, but I'm gonna leave just a little bit there for kind of the tail of our snail. But obviously our snail needs a head and maybe some little antlers, so I need another piece of tin foil. And I don't need a big piece here. I'm just gonna use kind of a, I don't know, maybe a quarter of a sheet, I'd call this. And I'm gonna wrap this around in the same kind of manner that I did before, but I'm actually gonna wrap it around this part of the end of my snail shell. That way the tinfoil is actually gonna stay connected to the rest of it. And I can unroll a little bit of this if I want to. Wait a minute. Oh, I messed it up. So, I'm gonna take that off there because I messed it up. So I'm gonna just wrap around a little bit at the bottom, and then you guys just probably heard me rip a piece of it. I'm gonna pull some of this around to the front and then squish it and make sure that it's stuck on there. Sorry about that. Roll that snail shell back up. So now I have this kind of piece up at the front that's nice and secure, and I have this back piece that needs a little bit of fussing with and polishing, but pretty good. Okay, so now I'm gonna make this part here into the snail's head. So I'm going to kind of start to crunch that all together. But before I crunch it all together, I'm just going to take this part that is going to be kind of the front end of my snail, and I'm just going to kind of pinch into two parts. And I could either leave it just like that, even though my snail's a little disproportionate, or I can actually just start to rip this tinfoil down the middle a little bit so that I can kind of fold these back and make them a little bit thicker and give myself a little bit more wiggle room when it comes to sculpting them and giving them, you know, a little bit of detail. You can't get a ton of detail because it's still tinfoil, but get a little bit. Okay, and there we go. We have a little snail. That is all ready for a puppet show, I would say. Okay, so the second thing we're going to do is a little bit more complicated than the snail. We're actually going to try to make a brown bear. Well, silver bear, I guess. So we'll jump right in. The first thing we're going to do is make the body. We're going to need kind of a bigger piece of tinfoil for this. So if, you know, you don't have too much tinfoil in your house and you want to save it for things that aren't art related, feel free to skip this one. Try to make some snails and see how that goes. See if it inspires you to make anything else. If you're swimming in tinfoil, then we're A-okay. Let's try to make that bear. So I'm gonna rip off kind of a bigger piece, like I said before. And what I'm actually gonna do is I'm gonna try to make kind of a teardrop shape. So I'm gonna have kind of a rounder end on the bottom, and it's gonna come up to a point. And we're actually gonna use that as the body of the bear. So I'm just gonna start by kind of crunching up this bottom. And then trying to just kind of round, or not round, but point that top part. So that's pretty close to a teardrop shape there, but this part is a little flimsy. So I'm gonna use another piece of tin foil to just kind of stiffen this up, make it a little bit more sturdy. Okay, so that is much better. I have kind of a nice ball down here, and then it comes up to a pretty good point. So now I have to make four legs, I have to make a head, and maybe some ears. I can't remember if a bear has a tail or not. I don't think it does, so we're gonna skip a tail. So first, I'm gonna do a very similar thing to what I just did. But I'm just gonna try to wrap this first part and leave a lot of excess at the top here to form that into a ball to make the head. So as you can see, I just wrapped that tinfoil around kind of the bottom half, and I have a lot of excess up here to try to round off and make that bear head. I remember bears being a little pudgy, so I'm not going to give too much definition down here. But I am going to try to give this a little bit of shape, so it almost looks like the bear is kind of bending its back and bending over to get a little sip of water. And again, in this area, it's a little flimsy, so I'm going to go ahead and add some more tin foil there. To try to smooth out the transition from the kind of back of the body to the front of the body. But I don't want to lose the definition from where the bear's head was, which I just kind of lost. So I gotta just kind of try to re-sculpt that in. That's pretty good. And you may have noticed when I'm forming this tinfoil, I'm kind of working in layers. And what that does is that really allows me to kind of keep all the pieces connected. So now I'm actually gonna try to form some back legs here and some front legs, and I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna take this piece of tinfoil, I'm gonna wrap it around the whole piece, and then I'm gonna just kind of squeeze some legs off of this back part. Okay, I just made it look a little bit like E.T. Same thing back here. The legs aren't that strong, so I'm gonna use another piece of tin foil. Just try to beef it up a little bit. Okay, we're getting there. So let's try to get some front legs on there. Let's see if this will stand yet. Not quite. It's okay. We're gonna aim to have it stand this way anyway. But okay, that could just stay. So I'm going to take another one, and I'm actually going to make this into kind of a longer strip, because I'm just going to wrap this around here. To make these long front paws. There we go. Now it's starting to look a little bit like a bear. Add just another piece kind of across the back here, because I just put this little hump in here, so I'm going to try to get rid of that. As I said before, this one's a little bit more complicated than the snail, but we're doing great. Okay, so I think that's looking pretty close to a bear so far. All it really needs is maybe some ears and a little snout. So I'm gonna take this piece, and I'm just gonna start by kind of wrapping it around the head and just trying to pinch some little ears up so our tinfoil just kind of sticks up. One over here. Oh, just lost it. There we go. One over here. And maybe one over here. No, I might have to do this in two pieces. But there you can see one of the ears coming up right here. Other ear on there. They're not perfect, but it's the best thing about art, right? It doesn't have to be perfect. It can just be fun. Now I have a little section just around the neck that I would like to smooth out a little bit. So I'll give our bear a little cape really quick. Pull some of that up into the ear, scrunch some of it down to smooth out the neck, and then scrunch the rest down on the body. Legs just needed a little bit of reinforcement, so I'm just helping them out. Okay. So we're almost done with our bear. I just need to do a little bit more detail up at the face, and then I think we're pretty much done. So I don't know if you guys can see. I think you can. The face is looking okay. I don't really love the ears. So the great thing about this tinfoil sculpture is I can just take a big piece of tinfoil and put it right over top of the, right over top of the face and essentially start over with the face. So I'm going to try that because I'm not totally happy with it. So, I can't decide. Okay, I am. I'm going to put this right over the face here. I'm going to take a little bit of that tinfoil and just kind of pinch it out to try to make a nose. And then I'm going to bring the rest up to make those ears much better. A little piece on our belly that's not totally attaching here. Tuck it on, fix that. Squeeze everything together a little bit better. A reinforcement, and luckily this tin foil makes the bear look a little bit more pudgy, which is exactly what I want. A bear that's just about to go into a bear that's just about to go into hibernation. Okay, and there we go. That's my bear made out of tinfoil. Oh, he's definitely about to go into hibernation. Okay, you did it. Another video, check it off the list. Another skill to stick in your back pocket. Good job. You saw some examples. Hopefully you saw how easy it is to set a scene with all these funny little tinfoil characters. So I encourage you to explore that. See what happens. Maybe you can make a puppet show. Maybe we can do a stop animation movie later on. It'll be great. Either way, send us your results. Can't wait to see them. See you guys soon.